Alright fam, I'm trying to make this video without it going too weird. I mean, the color's already kind of all over the place, but we'll try and get through it. So, welcome to 2022. This is a new year, but the same me. Ambitions, ambitions, ambitions. And we start off this year with Spanish. So a quick recap, I don't know, a quick something relating to me learning languages. Last year, and for most of the years prior to last year, I've really wanted to learn Spanish. If you look deep in the channel, there's been times where I've started Spanish. I've had this book for a long time. I think the most I'd ever gotten through to it was looks like maybe 8 or 10, less than 8 or 10. And that was really the extent of my Spanish. I mean, I had done also, I believe, Pimsleur, maybe even some Michel Thomas at one point. But all that's for naught. At the end of last year, I told myself 2022 is the year for a focused attempt at Spanish. No matter what happens with French, at the end of 2021, you will start Spanish in 2022. And I kept to that. January began Spanish, and I began with Osimil. But then I received the email from BaseLang. They didn't just email me, they emailed everybody who was on the list. And they were saying that they were doing their once a year discount. And that discount was 129, so one basically 130, as opposed to the normal, I believe it's 149 or 150. Long story short, I said, yeah, let's go. It was a week free anyway. Not well, basically a week free. I think you pay like a dollar. And it was chill. The first week was okay. I was kind of into it, kind of not. It was tough to get classes. Tough to get classes. It was just the influx of people, seems like. So then they actually gave me an additional week on that, and that really did help solidify my interests in proceeding. So I went ahead and did that remainder of the month, into February. It was good, but I'm not gonna lie to you. I originally was kind of over it within that first month, and I'll tell you why. The reason is they have a very structured program, and I'll even show you that program. So let me switch. All right, very structured program. You'll see my current progress. And so this is like level zero, which is just survival stuff. Boom. Level zero felt great. I was like, oh, this is great. I'm learning. I'm learning, but I wasn't like speaking. I was speaking with the teachers, but I wasn't like speaking myself, but it was still okay. It was still okay. Let's just go into like this is basically hola, cómo estás, hasta luego, gracias, stuff simple, very simple, but needed. Survival. You need this stuff. Like survival two, what is this? This is like how to buy stuff. Let's go help and nothing. Again, you need this stuff. I was into it. Okay, then we get to level one, and this is where I was like, kind of was hitting a roadblock of like, all right, guys, enough with this basic-ish, you know, vocabulary. You need it, get it, great, boom, you know, boom, boom, boom. But yeah, I was doing this stuff, and it's, you're not really learning how to put sentences together at this point. You're just learning things, and I was getting tired of learning things. But, you know, long story short, I said, Ronald, trust the process. This has worked for many others, allegedly. I don't know. This has worked for many others. Just trust the process. So I kept going. I kept going. I had some really good teachers. I honestly, on the subject of teachers, I really only had maybe one that was just a seemingly waste of time, where we went to another website, and he just read a bunch of like rules on whatever grammar point it was. I don't even remember. That was a waste of time, like an hour, just like him, just horrible. And another time, the lady was nice, but her connection was not doing anybody any favors. And honestly, besides those two, it's been great. I mean, I've definitely met teachers that I connected with more, sure, but besides those two particular instances, it has been great when it comes to just having classes. Connections, I say 95% of the time are great. So, as you can see, just me scrolling through, there's a lot of, you know, not much happening here until you get to around this point. And, you know, you start learning more, started being able to make some kind of sentences, and, you know, that helps the morale. So, yeah, so I've tested all of that, and then we get to level two, and you learn a little bit more. The only complaint, really, I have with the structure of the lessons is I feel like you should learn how to say a past tense way earlier. You eventually get to past tense level 54. And there's another version of past tense I want to say in like chapter or level 4 or something like that. But this should be way higher up because it's so simple. But, you know, whatever. So that's my basic review, I suppose. And just to give a little highlight, let me see, class history. I actually really did use this. My most recently was the 13th. Yeah, I really used this. I did the math, and it's, I think it totaled me doing 54 lessons in a month and a half. And February really doesn't count because I didn't do that many lessons in February. Some of my favorite teachers, loved her, loved him, obviously, loved him. See, Victor, liked him. Actually, everyone are fine. All these people are fine. yeah, what else? Do I think you can become fluent just using BaseLang? Yeah, of course you can. Who do I think the... Let me go back to me. Me. All right. Who do I think would benefit most from the unlimited? Because it's important to know there is both an unlimited subscription, which is what I did up until today, actually. Today I switched to monthly, or lying, hourly. There we go. I switched to hourly. Okay, so unlimited. Like, if you don't get the 130 deal and you're locked in at the 150. I think BaseLang is great if you're starting from zero, like me. I basically started from zero, and it's definitely great for that. Also, unlimited is great if you are in upper intermediate advanced-ish speaker. Unlimited is great. There was times where I would, it would be like 10 o'clock, and I'm like, let me take a class. Boom, somebody's on. Normally that hour I feel like a lot of Spanish only, but recently they've added a lot of teachers I've seen, because there's a ton of people now. But I say if you're upper intermediate advanced and you just want to get some speaking again, you have like a random 30 minutes, great. The lessons get kind of old. I think after a certain point, like even where I'm at now with level two, I mean, maybe I could go through level three, but I feel like, which I'll discuss in another video, where I'm at now, I just need to be consuming relevant vocabulary and producing my own sentences. There's a module, I guess that's why not I'm here. There is a thing called electives, where technically this is supposed to be relevant vocabulary, and I guess it is, but you don't need 50, I mean, maybe you do. You don't need 46 words on travel. You know what you need. And you compound knowing what you need, if that makes any sense, by actually using the language and seeing what comes up in your actual conversations. So that's where I'm at now. I will continue using BaseLang because I need speaking practice where I don't care. No, that's not. How do I say it? Yeah, I guess so. Sure, I need speaking practice where I don't care to explain things to others, if that makes any sense. Because when you're using an app like Tandem, which I just started using again the other day, I'll talk about that in the next video. I feel like you have to give and receive, like either half the conversation or half of your communications is you helping the other person out as well, which is what you should be doing because that's what that platform is for. But something like BaseLang or one of the other tutor-based websites, you're there, you're paying them to get your questions answered, to get their insights about what you want to get. So I think BaseLang is great for absolute beginners. BaseLang as far as the monthly subscription. I think it as an hourly outlet is great for any and everybody. So yeah, absolute beginners, upper intermediate, advanced, people who want to speak often. If you don't want to have these more in-depth conversations more than say twice a week, then no, I don't think you need the monthly. You definitely don't need the monthly. You need the hourly. You'll make out better monetarily speaking. So yes, that's how I'm going to persist. I will do another BaseLang update in maybe, I don't know, another month or two. Until then, I will see you. If you guys want to sign up, give it a try. Of course, there is a referral link in the description because why not? I mean, I'm giving them free publicity as far as I'm concerned. Y'all can help me out. That'd be great. And just to prove to you, like, I'm not lying. How do I pay for this out of my own monies? Hold on. All right. There we go. Ooh, money, money. I paid for that. Just in case you guys are thinking my 180 subscriber account is getting free stuff. Yes, anyway, this is 15 minutes. Until next time, guys, which should be in about an hour. Thank you. Welcome back to those who have missed the... Welcome to those who are new. Yeah. All right.